Thank you. Thank you. see where the other four.
Seat protector and cargo liner back there. Waves out here, sock window deflectors, and mud flaps, and the bump step to keep the bumper dent free.
Cool.
It's the best protection for your vehicle. New or pre-owned.
Great.
We'll book where we'll order. WeatherTech.com.
Saying the refrigerator is empty. She's embarrassed to ask for help. Their need, as you can see, is extremely urgent.
Right now, you can give a gift of life of $25. The International Fellowship of Christians and Shepherds will bring comfort and food to Ranzia and thousands of others.
Ranzia has had such a hard life, and just seems to
your special holiday gift will provide everything they need to celebrate the holy season of Passover.
Ramzia saw this matzah that the fellowship brought on Passover. Ramzia was so excited and brings up memories of faith, family, her childhood.
I'm partnering with the International Fellowship of Christians and Jews. This trusted ministry has given Christians like me a way to tangibly bless Jewish people who are in need around the world.
A life-saving $25 gift helps send the volunteers one urgently needed survival food box.
For less than $1 a day, you can say, I will bless and comfort the Jewish people. I will save a life today.
Please forward, go online now and say, I will. Bless his people,
Israel. When a cyber thief transfers the title of your home out of your name, it's a race against time to stop the theft of your hard-earned equity. Many people don't know this has happened until long after it's found.
You as the homeowner think you still own a house. 3 months later, you start getting foreclosure notices, and you realize you've got four mortgages on your house that you didn't even know existed.
So when's the last time you checked on the title to your home? Find out if you're already a victim at HomeTitleLock.com.
I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you.
You feel any different?
I don't want you to feel anything to do great things.
Jesus, if you do not renounce your rules, we will have no choice but to follow the law of Moses.
I am the law of Moses.
With thyroid eye disease, I hid from the camera, and I wanted to hide from the world. For years, I thought my TED was beyond help. But then, I asked my doctor about Tepezza.
Tepezza is the only medicine that treats TED at the source, not just the symptoms. In a clinical study, more than 8 out of 10 patients taking Tepezza had less eye bulging. Tepezza is an infusion. Patients taking Tepezza may have infusion reactions. Tell your doctor right away if you experience high blood pressure, dyspepsia, shortness of breath, or nothing. Before getting Tepezza, tell your doctor if you have diabetes, IBD, or pregnant, or planning to become pregnant.
San Francisco spent years letting dealers and junkies do whatever they want, while they defend the police. And that turned the city into a murder magnet. A tech mogul was just stabbed to death on the street. Then the mayor's crying for help. Hey, feds, come rescue me. But why don't they start here? The drug dealers opened up a farmer's market. Dealers set up tents and tables, but they're not selling kale and rhubarb, which is certainly not a big fentanyl. And it's all out in the open. They're not even trying to hide it. Dealers bark out prices like it's the Chicago Commodities Exchange. A scrum of dirty junkies grows, and they do this every day. And the city doesn't even work at home. This could be the easiest drug bust in history, but the city's too busy debating reparations and canceling Abraham Lincoln Elementary. Drug tourism is exploding. Fiends pouring into the Tenderloin from all over the country. It attracts lost addicts slipping to cocktails and shootout cops.
You seem like you want it right there. What you want?
So pretty.
Some shrooms and some weed. The shroom. You're too young to be getting high. What other kind of drugs do you use?
J.J. Smith recorded these videos. So, J.J., when you talk to these people, what do they tell you?
They tell me they just want to get high.
And they know that's where to go to get it?
They know San Francisco is easier, is more access to get it.
Is there any sort of, I don't know, sadness? Do people realize they've hit rock bottom?
Well, some people realize it, but they still believe that it's still somewhere left up in them to go further. There's a lot of sadness. I'm sad. There's a lot of community members that say.
Do you think the city of San Francisco is sad? Do they even recognize how bad the problem is?
No, San Francisco don't believe it's a problem. They're not sad, not one bit.
San Francisco doesn't believe they have a drug problem.
He doesn't believe they have a drug problem. You got some supervisors that believes that it's not serious enough to do anything about it.
Do the supervisors ever walk the neighborhood streets and see in their own eyes how rapidly destructive this is?
The supervisor we have for this district, we have two of them. Actually, you have a Dean Preston. So they're Dean Preston, but they're going to this district. I have never seen them walk this district. I've never seen him walk the streets. Now, he might go on the outskirts around it, but come in the heart of it? No, he doesn't come in the heart of it.
All right, so the politicians don't even go there. What about Nancy Pelosi? She's the congresswoman there. She represents the city. She's left it for how long? Do you ever hear her or see her saying anything about this issue?
Who's Nancy Pelosi? That's what everybody wants to say if you ask me. Who's Nancy Pelosi?
My God, it's bad. When you're out and talking to these people, what do you tell them? Is there any sort of way you lift them up and tell them that they got to get out of this place because they're going to die on the street?
I try to speak to each and every person and build a relationship with them. To try to see if I can keep assisting them to get some type of treatment, some type of rehab. So you got to understand that each person out there, they all sit in circles and they all get high. They're all enabling each other. So I try to be that outcast out of them that don't get high and try to become that friend and talk to them and try to get them to leave the streets and go into some type of treatment.
Are there city workers that do what you do, or are you in your life?